Hi. To be able to use the IR remote commander and receiver for MECHA, first connect the receiver to the aux port of the controller. Then access the user interface of MECHA using a computer or device and, on the configuration page, find the Use Nodal Ninja IR remote option and make sure it is enabled. Check this checkbox if it is not already checked. And click the Apply button. Then access the row page. Two types of presets can be launched using the IR remote commander or controller buttons: the presets assigned to the numerical buttons of the controller, and the presets whose name begins with a power code. The first type. To assign a preset to a button, select the preset from the presets list and load it using the Load button. Then click the Save To button, for example, to assign it to the MECHA 2 button. The Override confirmation prompt is shown to let you decide what to do. Click OK. Enter a name. And click OK again. In the presets list, the name of this preset is Button 2, followed by the name you've entered in the name field. To launch the preset assigned to MECHA 2 button, press the 2 button on IR remote commander. Then either the left or right button to specify the direction of rotation. You may as well use the same controller buttons. The second type of presets. Let's see what a power code is. This is a maximum 7-digit code that you can create as follows. The first digit must be 0, and the next, a combination of the digits 1, 2, and 3, so that two identical digits are not in consecutive positions. The name of a preset should start with such a code, so that you can launch the preset with the IR remote commander or controller buttons. So select the preset from the presets list. And load it using the Load button. Then click the Rename button. Add a power code followed by a space to the beginning of the preset name. And click OK. To launch this type of preset, enter the preset power code using the IR remote commander or the controller buttons. Use the power button to enter 0. And see if MECHA's LEDs show the digit 0. One red LED at the bottom. And one green at the top. See the table of equivalences to understand what the LEDs show. Then continue to enter the rest of the code using the numerical buttons. 1, 2 and 3. Look at the LEDs and check if the code you've entered is correct. 0, 1, 2, 3 in our example. Press the power button to cancel, and enter the power code again, if necessary. Then press either the left or right button to specify the direction of rotation. You may as well use the same controller buttons. Thank you for watching.